Okay, I was asked by one of my viewers if capacitors could be used for crankcase heat in air conditioners and heat pumps. Well, yeah, they have been. It's not real common anymore, but it was done for quite a while, and I looked around and found this old diagram on an old GE pump. And maybe I can explain how this is going to work. Now, first, we need to understand a capacitor is a current limiting device. Because of its charge and discharge cycle through AC, it's going to limit the amount of power that can go through it. And the larger the capacitor is, the more power will go through it. So let's look at how this is wired up. Now, I'm going to start over here to the common. Now that's upstream of the main contactor, right there, goes to common through the start winding over to these two capacitors. Now this is kind of interesting because one of these capacitors is downstream of the contactor and one of them is upstream of the capacitor. These are run caps. The total of these two equals the run cap size or strength. And if I go back the other way and follow the power from here, with the unit off, the power is going to go through here. It's going to go through this capacitor. And you notice there's a resistor in that capacitor. Well, I'll explain that in a minute. But then the power is going to go through here. It's not coming from this one because this one's downstream of the contactor and goes over to the start winding. So there's a complete circuit there. Now, you say, well, it isn't really a capacitor is the crankcase heater. There's actually a resistor here. Well, there's a reason for that resistor, and power doesn't go through the resistor, at least not enough to make any difference. This is a very high resistance resistor, and what it's there for is to discharge this capacitor because it doesn't discharge when you shut off the power. Because its circuit goes up here, if I cut the power off, this one would stay energized. Okay, if you can understand that. But let's look at what happens then. Okay, power comes through this capacitor. And the amperage is limited by it comes through, goes through the start winding. And the start winding is actually a load. It's not much of a load, a very, very low resistance. But because it is a circuit, it's going to heat up those windings a little bit, which of course is going to do what all crankcase heaters do, is drive liquid refrigerant out of the compressor can. So, it's actually fairly simple. The wiring is a little bit different, but it's fairly simple. One thing I should note too, when you're just trying to figure this out, I would just eliminate this part right here. This is a part that is not always put in. It's a hard start kit. It's a little bit confusing because it has a wire that goes through this relay coil. But I would just ignore it for our purposes here. Anyway, that's how it works. Don't see it much anymore. Not sure why, but it isn't commonly used, but it was used for a number of years in air conditioning. I'm going to do a little demonstration and show you how these things actually work when they're powered up. Now, I've set up a circuit to test what kind of amperage will run through one of these capacitors when power is applied to it. Now, it's just power applied to it. I've just got a little cord here. I'm going to plug the cord in. It's essentially the same circuit that's in that compressor. The power actually goes through the windings of the compressor, but the windings of the compressor have very little resistance. So there won't be
much of a load on it. It is the capacitor that is providing this current regulation. Now when I plug this in, we're going to get an amp draw. Okay, I'm drawing 1/10 of 1 amp. Now that's on the 5 microfarad side. Now you see I shorted that out. Now you can see why that resistor was in there. Now I've got this set up on the 45 microfarad. And let's see what it draws now. Okay, we're drawing 1.9 amps. That would be a bit much for a crankcase heater. The 1/10 of an amp, that might be a little bit low, but 1.9 would be excessive for the amp draw for a crankcase heater. It's, you know, it reduces the efficiency of the equipment. Okay, that's the explanation for the use of a capacitor to act as a crankcase heater.